to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number nine of our Building RubyGem NerdDice series. And in this item, we're going to look, we created some and added some items to our backlog and the issues log here in our previous video. And now we're going to try to tackle one of these. So we're going to start here with fix existing RuboCop offenses. I said it right this time. And so we're going to try to knock this one out. This one here, we're going to try to backport into version 0.1 as well. So if we look at our git status here and our git branch, so we've got master and version 0.1 stable, and master has one more commit on it than version 0.1 does. So if we've got just that extra commit that bumps the version. So when we do this, we're going to check it out off of the commit, the last commit that we have in common between the two. Ordinarily, you'd always create your feature and branch off of master, but in this case, we'll go with the last common commit we have between them, and then we'll do our development, and then we'll merge it into version 0.1, rebase it against master, and then merge it into master. So we're going to start by checking out a new branch. So we kind of decided to call this branch tech, and then the GitHub issue number for fix RuboCop offenses. We'll throw in a couple of zeros there. So now we've got a new branch, and we can start looking at our RuboCop offenses. So the first one we're going to take a look at is the gem spec one here. So we ran into this when we were trying to power through and release our gem, and we kind of deferred fixing it. So that if you look at the documentation here, string.endWith, so you can take a an array of suffixes, but those suffixes, we want them to be a string. I did this wrong in a few videos ago, so we're going to try to get this solved and buildable. So we're going to change this. End with, save it, RuboCop again. Over 13. But gem spec seems to be gone. We're going to try to build this to make sure that we're not breaking anything. We do have a warning about our certificate, but otherwise it worked. Although I did, you can see here, we're using 0.2, so I want to change my branch here before we commit anything. But it did build successfully, so we'll remove that, build gem. And then, so we're going to save what we've done so far. And then we're going to reset hard to this commit. That looks good. Still on that branch. Try this again. We're going to change, we're going to go into our certs directory, see if we can fix that issue. So right now it's 600 for that that .pem file. We're going to change that so that it's readable by group and user, that's not, that's our public certificate, not our secret key. So try the gem build again. Now we've got a failure. It looks like it was just the case that I fat fingered my my pass key there. So it did build successfully. We can remove it. Some of these are auto-correctable, and they're all, if we look at the bin generate checksums, they're all about double quotes and single quotes and spaces and stuff like that, so we're going to try to auto-correct as much as that as we can. Before we do that, we've got working progress, so we're going to do a quick commit here. We'll squash after we're done, but we'll at least get our progress saved in case we need to revert back to it. Now we'll do RuboCop. We're down to 6 offenses. All of those offenses were in the generate checksums item. So, and they were all related to cosmetic quote and spacing type stuff. So we'll commit that. Now we're down to our RSpec offenses. So part of this is it's complaining about our nesting. So let's take a look at the spec that we've got here. So right now we've got this this describe block in between here. It doesn't really add much value. So what I'm going to do, since we might have instance methods and stuff like that, we're going to try to refactor this out into a separate file. So we're going to create a directory And so now we'll create a class method spec here. So we go here now. There's an empty file. Spaces two. Keep version number here. Wonder if I can do something like this. Not super. See if we can now go in here. Get rid of this. We still have all right, so now let's see if we still are passing here. So we've got now our tests are still passing. Let's see how the cops are. So we're down to 4. We're still dealing with too many lines here. So since we're still working, we're going to commit again. And here, we'll note the information about the convention here. So instead of class methods here, we can just do dot total dice. That will remove a nesting level. We'll fix our indenting. Still working here. Are we down to 3 with RuboCop? We're down to 3. And there, there's the spec path warning there. So we want to rename this file. We'll close it in our editor. So we'll move working. Down to 2 offenses. And both of these are related to the metrics block length. So I did a little bit of research while we were paused here in the line block size for RSpec tests. It's really not tenable to have a 25-line block for RSpec just because of the way that the DSL is done. So we're going to take a look at this metrics block length and add an exclude pattern to it in our .rubocop file. So we've got our .rubocop.yaml. Layout and lint here. See if that solves our problems. Still down to 2. We also want to add our gem spec to that, which it looks like it may have been there by default in some way. No offenses detected. Yay. Make sure that we're still passing. We're still passing. And now we're going to go, and we're going to, I also want to, we'll commit because we've got all of our offenses taken care of.
Now our working directory is clean. So we've got our items here, and we're gonna try to coordinate our. Let's take a look at our NerdDice item here. I think we're good to keep the total dice method where it is for now. So we have done what we set out to do, and we will now we're going to rebase first against the reburn fix up. And that will actually that'll work for our for a short message. I'll pause and write my long message. So we've got our final commit message here. We'll write it. So that looks mostly good. Except for the fact that for some reason we didn't wrap that line. Well, we're also going to go and add in our change log, so we'll have to do another fix up on this. So in our change log, we'll add in today is December 12th, and we've got some fixes here. Two bug fixes here in 0.1.1. So that works for our items. We'll, since this is being we'll just leave that as is for right now. We're not going to duplicate it in both the master and the bug fixes section here. We'll save that. We will just run our rebase again. Oh, yeah. All reword slightly to fix that line issue. Now we'll update the commit. Everything's looking good, so we will push this to a new branch on origin. Go to GitHub now. Got our new branch. So it's showing one commit ahead, one commit behind master. I'm going to go to pull requests. Do a new one. And we're going to want to do fix RuboCop first into version 0.1 stable. Create that pull request. So let's take a look at this. That's what we want. So when I go back and I'm going to try to merge this via the command line. So I know what my branch names are. I'm going to do a fast forward merge here. See if this, you can see merging from the command line. If you are a authorized person on the pull request, it automatically marks that as merged. Now we're going to do the same thing for master. So we're going to now that now, and we're going to rebase this against master. Make sure our log looks like what we want it to. Force push. So the other one remains closed, but now I can go in and create a new pull request here into master. Pull request. Check out master. Do a fast forward merge. Push. Go to number 4. And it's closed. Automatically. When you get it into master. So, pretty slick. Now we're going to go and now in our 0.1, we're going to go in and bump our version to 0.1.1. Add an annotated tag here. I haven't done a lot of tagging yet, so we're going to grep our history. Thank you for the fatal error there, Git. Now we're going to gem build. Move that gem to our package directory, which is ignored. push. Now let's take a look at Ruby gems. Now it's showing a 0.1.1. Our change log works. And now we're going to do little commit and we're going to our status is up to date. And we're going to run our whatever the name of that generate checksums. Here. Now if we go and we look, we should have our checksums. 256 should match what we've got in Ruby gems. Three B eight F seven two. So that's working. And since this is such a minor operation, I'm not going to use the pull request process for this. So we're going to push the tags, but without the version. items are the way we want them. We've pushed to version 0.1 stable. Make sure that that is working as we intended it to. Mark that release in a second. Let's just make sure that version 0.1 has what we want. Master. Rebase interactively against master now, because we don't want the first item. We're going to drop this and just keep the generate set checksums commit. Just got the checksums commit. Now we're going to go to master. Fast forward, not possible. Master here. This is why you do fast forward only, by the way. So some reason we still kept release version 0.1.1 there. Oh, because we've got the tag. All right, so we're just going to pause for a second. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to master and I'm going to cherry pick this commit. Now should be good. So push here, can delete our old branches. Capital D here because we did fully merge it, or as fully as we wanted to, into the branches we wanted. So we've got our branches, our master branch. We look at our commit history. We'll go in and draft a new release. Target a specific commit here. So we're going to go to 1.x stable and just so somehow I managed to pull in this start version 0.2.10 commits. So we have on our version 0.1, we've got all of the right commits. I don't know what I did locally, but the fix local in a minute here. Let's go back to releases. We're going to draft a new release. Target specific commit. That release. Back to our code. Releases. So we know that the remote is correct for version 0.1 stable. So we're going to go to the latest commit that we know we had success here. Now we have our checksums, we have our RuboCop offenses, we've got our 0.1.1 and our checksums. Those are the four commits that we want. Looking good. Make sure that master has what we want here. So here we have 0.2, we have our commit, and we have our checksums. So that's, we have our latest release mark there. So we, and our issue is closed. So we'll pick up and knock out another issue next time.
Thanks for watching this stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.